Do you want to know which one is better, autosomal, Y-DNA, or mitochondrial DNA? Well, today I'm going to go over what you can learn from each one. As with many questions about DNA and about genealogy in general, the answer is always, it depends. When you say which is better, what is your criteria for better? What do you mean by that? So I have to make some assumptions as you're watching this video of what you mean by better. And maybe you can actually use this to help create a better question to ask about DNA, and we'll answer that one as well. So my guess is you probably are not concerned about price. You know, which one is better is not really a price standpoint. Clearly, autosomal DNA is better in that regards because you can get the autosomal DNA test for as cheap as $49, whereas Y-DNA and mitochondrial DNA tests start in the hundreds of dollars. My assumption when I'm thinking of better with this question is that which one answers more genealogy questions or which one answers a specific genealogy question. And that's really the answer to which one is better. Whichever one answers the question you have, that's the better one. Now, just from knowing how genealogy works and having done genealogy and having different genealogy questions, I can say that autosomal DNA probably answers more questions than any other since it covers more relatives. Autosomal DNA covers the whole spectrum from your father's 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 line all the way to your mother's 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 line, every line in between for about 5 to 7 generations. So there are hundreds of different genealogy questions that you might have in that group of people. And autosomal DNA might be able to help you answer some or most or many of those questions. On the other hand, Y-DNA and mitochondrial DNA are better in the sense that they go back farther, but they are for specific lines. In other words, Y-DNA is passed down from father to son to son to son to son. If you have a question that is on your father's 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 mother's mother's line, Y-DNA is not going to help you at all. But if you have a question that's on your father's 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 line, then Y-DNA might be able to help you solve that question. On the other hand, mitochondrial DNA comes from your mother. So if you have a question on your mother's 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 line, then mitochondrial DNA might be able to help you solve that question. Now, the other caveat I would apply, though, to the Y-DNA and the mitochondrial DNA is that you rarely are going to answer the question with just the DNA. And this really applies to autosomal DNA as well. There's going to be some other genealogical research that has to happen. For very few questions, is DNA standalone? But DNA can be a good tool to add to your genealogy toolbox. Now, when it comes to what test do I recommend to people, I recommend people take an autosomal test first because it is the broadest and it's probably going to answer many more questions than what the Y-DNA or the mitochondrial DNA is going to answer. But as you have done your research and if you have specific patrilineal questions or matrilineal questions, then you may consider getting a Y-DNA test or a mitochondrial DNA test. But one thing to remember with any of these tests is DNA is not going to answer all of your genealogy questions. You're not going to be able to take a test and slap it in a program and magically have a tree appear. That's not how it works at all. You don't share DNA with all of your relatives. And the further distant you are related to them, the less of those relatives that you actually share DNA with. So there are lots of people that DNA is not going to help you find simply because you don't share DNA with them. But that shouldn't dissuade you from jumping in the water and trying out an autosomal DNA test and seeing what you can do with that in your genealogy research. I did a recent video about mitochondrial DNA that you can watch right up here, but if you want to learn about something else, then try this video down below. Clearly, but it is a good tool.